Why Water Baptism, Part 6. I'm Professor Hannes Redlinghuis of the First Assembly of Yahushua in South Africa, Pretoria, Montana. Should you require any of the books which I've written, or the restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible, the Rottenham version, which is not available in any bookshops in the world, which I have a couple of copies, you can contact us at WhatsApp 0722-367-124. That's a plus 27 international code. Or you can just go to my website https://yahvah.co.za. If this is the first time that you will participate in the study, very welcome. But go to part one so you can start from the beginning. We have already covered quite a bit of information just in last week. It's also very important to subscribe so that you can receive the notifications of the different studies that we are currently busy on internet. I would also ask you to share the links with your friends and family. Make sure that you have a 1611 King James Bible at least, pen and paper ready, so that we can participate in the study. It's very important to listen to the announcement. It's important to know that we do not associate ourselves with the following people: any messianic groups, the Israel Vision groups, the Hebrew Roots movement, the Sacred Name movement, the Yah movement. We are not part of the Jehovah Witnesses or Seventh-day Adventists. Instead, we are not affiliated with any church, denomination or organization in the world. We are only an end-time Bible study group functioning throughout the world. We are mainly using the ancient Hebrew Sacred Name Bible according to the 1860 restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible, the Rottenham version, which was translated by Dr. Joseph Briant Rottenham in 1860. This is one of the oldest English stroke Hebrew Bibles you can lay your hands on, which I have a couple available should you be interested. According to this original ancient Hebrew Sacred Name Bible, the restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible, the Rottenham version, the name Jesus was originally Yahushua. Listen to the name. The name God was originally Elohim or Hashem. The name Lord was originally Yaffa. The name of the Holy Spirit was originally the Ruach HaKodesh. We refer to ourselves as Yahvists and not as Christians, according to 1 Peter 4 verse 16, in the restoration of the original Sacred Name Bible. As the disciples and the apostles and followers of Yahushua did 2,000 years ago. I trust that this study will be a blessing unto you in the wonderful name of Yahushua. Unfortunately, every morning I need to just quickly make this announcement because we have people that associate ourselves with the Jehovah Witnesses or the Seventh-day Adventists or any of the other names which I've mentioned. Welcome to Breakfast with Prof. Hannes. This is our breakfast session every morning, Monday to Fridays, if Yaffa tarries to come. Why water baptism? In this series, I will ask a lot of questions. We will have to study a lot of scripture. And when we study the scriptures, we need to look at every letter, not just a word, every letter. Because basically every letter has a meaning. And this is where we went wrong. Since we were small children, we learned to read the Bible in verses. We read the verse and we try to understand the verse. Where if we could read the letter or the word and the line, then you will understand the verse. But we learn just to scan with our eyes, just to scan the verse, and then we think we knew it. Yahushua went to John the Immerser. We refer to not the baptizer, but the immerser. Because I did explain to you last week the difference between immersing and baptism. Matthew 3 verse 13 and onwards. Matthew 3 verse 13 for those who are making notes. Everybody should make notes. The scriptures need to be studied again. That's why you need to make notes. Matthew 3 verse 13. Then cometh Yahushua from Galilee to the Jordan unto John to be immersed or baptized by him. Now most of the English Bible says baptize. No, it's immerse. So what did Yahushua did? He went to John with a request. Now, I just want to ask a question right here. Why would Yahushua go to John the Immerser to be immersed? Did he have sin? No. He became sin when he died on the wooden cross. Because the word of Yahweh says, cursed is he that dies on a wooden cross. There was a curse on the Roman cross, whether it was a pole or a cross, or you can call it what you like. But the Romans used the Roman cross to kill people, and it was a cursed instrument. Now Yahushua went to John to be immersed, not because he had sins in his life, but obedience to Yahweh, his father. Now as we continue with the study, we will understand why he had to be obedient to his father Yahweh. Verse 14. But John forgot him, that is Yahushua, saying to John, saying, I need to be immersed by thee. So John forbade him, that's Yahushua. He went against him. He said, whoa, I can't. Saying, I need to be immersed by thee, and thou comest to me? And comest thou to me? You see, immediately John recognized Yahushua as the Redeemer, the prophesied Redeemer of Israel that was prophesied by Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Daniel, and. That he would come as the Redeemer, the Savior, the Messiah of the nation of Israel. And even John the Immerser, he couldn't understand why Yahushua would want him to immerse him. And that's why he said, I need to be immersed by thee, and cometh thou to me? It didn't make sense to him. But this was all part of being obedient. Many a times in the last 56 years, while I was busy with studies, well, I'm still busy with studies and research works and writing books about the end time preaching and teaching, people will ask me, Prof, why did Yahushua had himself immersed? Did he have sin? Every time I would say, he's sinless, he was sinless. He became sin on the cross, on Calvary. But listen to Yahushua in verse 15. And Yahushua answering said unto him, suffer it to be now. Suffer it to be now. For thus it cometh us to fulfill the righteousness. It did what? For thus it becometh us to fulfill all righteousness. Right, to fulfill all righteousness means to be obedient. Unto who? Unto Father Yahweh, the Father. Let us be obedient and do what we need to do. Why? Because it's all part of the plan of Yahweh, our Elohim, to have the nation of Israel saved. Now, why do I say the nation of Israel? Because Yahushua came for his nation, the Israelites, stroke Jews. He came for Israel. He says, I've come to my own, and they receive me not. Yahushua's time of ministering on earth was 3 years. Two of the first 3 years, he only ministered to Israel. Israel, Israel, Israel. He actually told his disciples, don't give your bread to the dogs. Don't feed the dogs. What does it mean? Don't take your piece of bread and feed it to the dogs. No, 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 no. Don't take the gospel of salvation and feed it to the Gentile people, the Samaritans and all the others, the Greeks and all the other nations. Don't feed them. You are the elect, which is Father Yahweh's people, the nation of Israel. He's come for them, and he preached the gospel of salvation for 2 years only unto the nation of Israel. It was only in the third year that Father Yahweh turned the vision, turned the message of salvation from Israel, from his nation, Israel, unto the Gentiles. And that's why Yahushua went to the lady, the Samaritan lady, woman, at the well, and he asked her water. She said, but you are a Hebrew man. How do you ask me water? I'm a Gentile. I'm a Gentile. I'm a Samaritan. Now, the Maynard Concordance shows that the Samaritans was a mingled nation of 10 different bloodlines. Because she says, my great 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 father Jacob, this was his well. Great 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 father grandfather Jacob. This was his well. So she also had Israelite blood in her. And Yahushua said, if I give you of my water, fountains of living water will spring up till eternity. You see, but you don't even have a mug or something to drink from. You see, she was thinking with her cardinal mind. And Yahushua had another plan. So on that moment that he spoke to the first time spoke to the Gentile, lady, the Samaritan woman, the gospel was taken away from the nation of Israel. And it was presented to the Gentiles for the first time. And then Yahushua told about the parable. He spoke about the guy that was lying in the road, and the Pharisee came past, and the priest came past, and then came a Gentile. And he picked him up. And he took him. And that was most probably a Jew or an Israelite that was laying, that was mud. And the Gentile picked him up, taking him to the house. And he told the person there, I will pay for this man, fix him up. When I come back and you need more money, I will pay you more money. So what happened? It was not the Israeli guy or the Jew that picked the Gentile up. It was the Gentile that picked up the Hebrew guy or the Israelite or the Jew that was mucked, that was injured, taking him to the inn. That is all part of the figurative speech. It's a story that Yahushua was telling. And Yahushua is telling this parable in figurative speech. And Israel didn't understand it. Actually, very few people understand what he was talking about. But for us, as part of the bride of Yahushua today in this 21st century, we understand the word. We understand the figurative speech. We understand today that the message of salvation had to go to the Gentiles first. Because before the coming of Yahushua on the clouds for his bride can occur. Now, if I do my calculations right, it was 1 year after 2 years or 3 years ministry. Ministering to just to the Israelites the first 2 years. From the third year up till today in 2024, the message of salvation was never ever preached unto the Jewish people ever again. Here and there, You will find somebody that will speak to an Israelite or a Jew. And here and there you will find one Israelite or Jew that will come to repentance, be immersed in the name of Yahushua. And what happened to them? They become part of the bride of Yahushua. They are not only circumcised by the flesh, but they are circumcised by the spirit, by the soul's dimension. The Bible says he has no desire that we will be circumcised in our flesh, but in our hearts. You can't be circumcised in your heart. In your mind, in your soul's, from there to there is your soul's dimension. And this is where everything is happening. On the end of the day, the message has gone away from Israel. After 2 years of ministry of Yahushua's life, we was a 3 years period of ministry time. And from the end of the second year up till today, it will happen up to the day that Yahushua will come. At the end of Revelation 3:22, the time of grace. We're living in the age of grace. And the day that grace will stop is the day when Yahushua will appear on the clouds, so that he will not rapture, but he will parousia. He will take the bride away. Parousia. The rapture, the harpazo, happens in Revelation 19, verse 6 to 11. Now time has caught up with us. We'll speak about this tomorrow morning. Maranatha, Yahushua's coming back again. Have a wonderful day. Hallelujah.